This is the next example for momentum, and in this example you have a system of two runners. We have one sprinter, it's going 65 kilograms going east, and another one 10 meters per second at 200 meters per second. Then the other person is 75 kilogram sprinter running north at 9.5 meters per second. So if we would look at the two, we have one sprinter going this way at 10 meters per second, and we have another sprinter going in this direction at 9.5 meters per second. We need to find out what the momentum of the two actually is together. So in order to do that, lots of people say, well, you just take the two momenta and you add them together and that should be the resulting momentum, and you cannot do that. You have to be very careful with this one. We need to find out what the sum of the different momenta are in each direction. So essentially what we're doing is, if we redraw this system, you've got one runner going this way, the other one going this way. We need to find this side because that would be the sum of the two momenta. So we have the momentum in the x, we have the momentum in the y, and our overall momentum then will be the hypotenuse of that triangle. So let's go through and do that. We know that the absolute value of the momentum, so not really worried about direction here, is equal to the square root, because this is what we're looking for. We're going to take the hypotenuse squared is equal to one side squared plus the other side squared. We can put these in. We're going to say this is the sum of the momentum in the x direction squared plus the sum of the momentum in the y direction squared. Obviously this one is only in the y direction, so this is the momentum in the y, and this one is only in the x direction, so this is the momentum in the x, or the sum of the momentum in the x. We can plug our numbers in, so we end up with, in the x direction we have 10 squared, plus in the y direction we have 9.5 squared, and so you should end up with about 964, and then this week could either be kilogram meter per second or a newton times a second. In order to find the direction, the thing that we need to do is we've got to find this angle. So in order to find that angle, we're going to use the inverse tangent function. We'll say the inverse tangent, and it's because this is the opposite, this is the adjacent side, so tangent of the angle will be equal to the sum of momentum in the y divided by the sum of the momentum in the x. So we can solve just for the angle itself by saying the inverse tangent of the sum of the momentum in the y divided by the sum of the momentum in the x direction. And because we only have one y and one x direction, this is very simple, so it's just tangent negative 1 of 9.5 divided by 10, and you end up with 47.6 degrees, and for this it would be north of east. And so our final answer would be 964 newtons per second at, I would always put the at sign in, at 47.6 degrees north of east, and that is a combination of a couple of different momenta that we're trying to add together.